something very chill, focusing on stretching some key areas in the body. My shoulder's been giving me some issues, so I think it'd be nice to maybe work on some shoulders, and then we can get into some hips as well. So if you're here, then we're gonna begin at the top of our yoga mat. So stretching out those toes a little bit, maybe rolling out the ankles, relaxing the shoulders, shaking out the hands. And a couple good breaths in and out through the nose. Maybe sending a few exhales out the mouth. And really starting to generate some good flow with the inhalation and the exhalation. Feeling grounded through the feet, long through the spine, relaxed in the shoulders, soft in your face. And we're going to start to add some movement from here. So as you continue to press down through the feet, take your arms and reach them up to the sky. A good inhale to stretch out the fingertips. And an exhale to fold forward into a bend. Letting your head and neck relax. The muscles in your face. And the feet can be a little further apart or closer together, whatever feels most comfortable, but I would encourage you to explore a little bit, right? Feel out those hamstrings. Shift side to side, maybe bend the knees a little bit. I'm saying hello to the hamstrings this morning. And doing your best to get some good breath circulating. We're gonna add some movement from here. So on an inhale, take your hands right above the kneecaps. We're gonna lift the heart, relax the shoulders. We wanna keep the belly happy and open here. So as you continue to press down through the hands, lift the sternum. Breathe in, and on an exhale, fold. We're gonna do that a couple more times, inhaling to a strong extended spine. Exhaling to relax. Once more like that, inhaling. And exhaling. So what I love about yoga is just you can add as much flavor as you'd like, you know. Add in some spice, or if you've got more of a sweet tooth, add in some sweetness. A little bit of movement here and there, right? We want to keep those muscles limber and active. So from here, I want you to visualize little roots growing out of the feet, digging deeply into the earth. And what we're going to do is gently roll up through the spine. Kind of like a puppet coming to life. And when your head comes up, on an inhale, stretch your arms up to the sky. And an exhale, drop the arms. Shake it out. Letting any energy that you may be holding on to go. And that's the key with yoga, detachment, loosening things out, and freeing yourself from resistance. So we're going to keep flowing. On an inhale, reach up. On an exhale, take it forward. Inhale to extend the spine. On an exhale, place both hands to the floor and step back to a plank position here. We're going to be actively pressing down through the fingertips, through the toes. You want to pull things to midline. So as you press, we're going to be squeezing the arms, gently squeezing the belly. You'll notice that my shoulders are super relaxed. Jaw relaxed. It's about using the muscles intelligently here as we press and engage what we need to engage and relax what we need to relax. So keep the breath flowing. From here, we're going to stretch it into our first downward facing dog. And again, you know, you can add movement, you can walk your dog, broaden the shoulders a little bit. You know, it's a good opportunity to take a look at your mat, notice if there's any dust, and then you can wipe that away. We want to focus on some positive extension through the spine here, and the best way to achieve that is by bending the knees and trying to focus your awareness on the tailbone. This way we can shift side to side through the tailbone, we can scoop, we can extend, and what we're looking for is that extension. Continuing to press down through the fingertips, keeping the shoulders strong and the upper back solid. As we breathe, we find movement through the spine. Extension, length, space. Why not? Let's start up a little flow here. We're going to get up onto our tippy toes, and I'd like you to step your right foot between the palms, and we're going to set up for a high lunge position. So making sure that this knee is stacked right over the ankle, we're going to press and lift the chest. And as we lift the chest, we're going to relax the shoulders, relax the face, hands on hips. And we just want to pay attention closely to the muscles as they squeeze, right? They're firing up, maybe feeling a little bit of burn through the glute, through the top of the left thigh. And we just stay present. We observe the muscles, we observe the energy flowing through the body and mind. If you'd like, you can reach up, creating a bit more extension and lift through the heart. Slowing things down. And hopefully that right leg is getting tired by now. What we're going to do is take our hands back down to the floor, and we're going to step back into another plank position. So from here, it's up to you. If you'd like to move through chaturanga, it's a great sequence. Stick with your breath. If not, just hold plank. Breathe. And then meet us in downward facing dog. So we're going to try that on the other side, getting up onto the tippy toes, stepping the left foot between the palms. Strong foundation here, lifting up through the heart and settling. It's about finding the pose, but then letting go of your ideas or descriptions about the pose. The truth of yoga is getting into the essence, really the core of the body and heart, which then reveals freedom, openness, fluidity, and most importantly, creativity. When we're able to slow the mind, we can start to see new ideas, new thoughts, new feelings. And the reason why that is because we're not so attached to the other things that are circling or cycling through our mind over and over and over. So hopefully we've got some good squeeze on this left glute and top thigh. We're going to take both hands to the floor, step back to another plank pose. Again, either hold or move through chaturanga. Downward facing dog. Let's go down to the hands and knees. And we're going to do a variation on child's pose. So, settling back through the hips. Feeling that out, maybe the knees are close together or a little further apart. We're going to take our hands and walk them over to the left, reaching out through our right fingers here. And what we want to do is expand all that muscle tissue here, on the right side of the body. You might feel it through the waistline, and if you do, keep breathing. Give those muscles some good energy. All right, switching out to the other side here, extending out through the left hand. Again, just visualize this welcoming of energy, right? We welcome the breath, we welcome oxygen into the system, increased blood flow, circulation. And it's very supportive energy. We are supporting ourselves, we are supporting our experience. Alrighty. So we're going to take it back to center, press it on up to the hands and knees. And from here, I honestly thought it would feel nice to kind of just shift around through the shoulders a little bit and move side to side through the hips. Maybe some cat-cow if you feel like your spine needs a little more attention. But we'll give this a few solid ones. Follow your intuition. If the mind carries you away, focus back in on the feeling rather than the thought. Okay, downward facing dog. We're gonna add on to our little sequence here. So this time we're actually going to take our right foot and lift it back and up to the sky. We're gonna keep our hips squared, neck relaxed, stretching out those toes, rolling out the ankle maybe. But really continuing to firmly press down through the hands, right? We want to press that energy up and back as we extend and breathe. And when you're feeling ready, we're going to step that through, setting up for a twisted high lunge. So we're going to start with both hands on this right leg. And what I want you to do is just manually twist yourself open, right? If you can see that, I'm pressing down to help twist the belly, relax the shoulders. If you want, you can even take your left elbow on the outside of the right knee. I like to keep my right hand on the thigh for support. We're just breathing. Use the strength of those legs. Get in there. Cultivate some good energy. Alrighty. From here, we're going to take one more breath. Make it count. Man, that leg. Hopefully that's feeling on fire, because we're going to release this over to the left for a wide-legged forward bend. Then we can kind of stretch side to side a little bit if you think that feels nice. In fact, I think that this pose really opens us up to a bit more exploration. Just because we have more space between the legs, we can swing, we can bend the knees, we've got a bit more flexibility here. So have some fun with it, and we'll continue soon. All right, lovely work. If you're feeling good about that, what we're going to do is take our hands, walk them back up to the top of our mat. But we're not done with our sequence yet. We're going to practice some standing balance. So let's take our hands back up to this right leg here. And all I want you to do is move from this high lunge up into a balance. Now, we're going to try that a couple times if it felt a little wobbly at first, just so we can get that motion dialed in. Right? Yoga is about doing the poses, but yoga is also about how fluidly you can transition, how present you can remain as you shift and go from one pose to the next. So we're going to keep it simple with our standing balance today. Let's press down firmly. Let's interlace the fingertips around this right knee, or excuse me, the left knee, I believe. We're going to relax the shoulders, concentrate the mind. And we just want all that muscle tissue here in the glute and the thigh, even down through the calf a little bit. We just want to wake up these muscles so they can feel alive, so they can get into their vibrancy. Alrighty, so from here, we're going to release the knee and then we're going to relax back down. Shake it out a little bit. And then we're going to start up our sequence on the other side. So when you're ready, on an inhale, reach up. On an exhale, go down. Inhale, extend halfway. Exhale, step the left foot back. And then the right foot, setting up for a plank position. Chaturanga or downward facing dog. And once you're in downward facing dog, take your left foot and reach it up to the sky. But again, I want you to consider that the more you press down through your hands and your fingertips, the more this right leg is going to want to lift. So we can stretch out those toes, we can breathe, we can maximize the energy here before stepping through. Setting up for our twisted lunge here, both hands on the left thigh. And again, what we want to do is just manually twist the belly. So we twist the belly, we settle in. Maybe that right elbow comes on the outside of the left knee. You're finding a nice point for your eyes to focus on. If our eyes aren't moving, then we're not taking in any more information than we need to. Instead, we can focus and stabilize. Harness the energy of your breath. Stay calm, collected. Lovely work, everyone. So we're going to fold over to the other side, but because you probably don't want to see my butt if you are tuning in, then I'm just going to switch it out. So we're going to do wide-legged forward bend. Should be good. Ooh, yeah, this leg right here. So if you find that you're really stretching one leg more than the other, then try alternating to the next. All right, see what you can do to kind of shift and move things around to stretch out that muscle tissue nicely. And you know, as we get in there, I would never say try to like force the stretch or take it too far, but you certainly can exaggerate some kind of shifting. Right now, I'm working specifically with the pelvis and the tailbone. So if I extend the tailbone back out to the right, then I'm going to be lengthening all those hamstrings, all that connective tissue in the inner thigh. It'll take about one to two more here to wrap this up. And finishing things off nicely, we're going to take our hands and walk them up to the top. And we're going to set up for our transition into that standing balance once again. So hands up on the thigh, pressing and lifting, just kind of feeling things out, right? Might feel more solid on this side, might feel less, right? My left leg is dominant, so this certainly feels a little bit more stable to me. All right. Interlacing the fingertips around this knee here, the right knee. I love this pose because it feels so solid. We're lifted, we're holding, we're pressing, and we are relaxing. Well, I'm going to say very good if you're there with me, even though I can't see you. So what we're going to do is release, relax, let things settle. And we're going to take one hand to the heart, one hand to the belly. And the key here is actually tucking the chin inward a little bit to help extend through the cervical vertebrae. We can tune into this long line of energy that travels up through the spine to the crown of the head. Relax those hands. On an inhale, reach up. Take your time exhaling down to the floor, inhaling to extend halfway, stepping back to a plank position, but this time we are going to lower all the way onto the belly. Now, I don't know how this is gonna do with the mic. In fact, I'm gonna take that mic off. I'm gonna place it right here. That's handy. So, our next situation is going to be stretching into the front of the shoulders. And then we're going to balance that with stretching the back of the shoulders. So really quick and dirty, we're going to take our right hand and reach it out to the right, palm to the floor. And we're going to take our left hand as leverage. We're going to press it down so that we can gently roll onto this right shoulder. I feel like whenever I do yoga practice or some stretching on my own, I always incorporate this one. Because it is so easy to get these muscles imbalanced. So we want to rebalance them as the muscles become shorter from just staying rounded through the shoulders. We can really manually open them up, let them breathe. Maybe one more just to wrap this one up. Really getting to a good place with it before switching out to the other side. And I love finding those imbalances in the body, you know, where one side feels tighter than the other. And the reason why is because I start to look at different areas of my life and how I'm holding my body, whether that's like sitting in my computer chair or even just sitting in my car or any kind of movements that I'm doing throughout the day, which, you know, maybe puts more dominance on one side than the other. And then you can start to make these little adjustments, you know, just those little bits of awareness that we can bring into our day to day that yoga really helps to stimulate. So we stimulate more awareness. We stimulate more breath. And
And hopefully by doing that, we feel more connected to the things around us rather than separate. Good. One last breath. Really make this stretch count. Make this one a good one. Oh, that feels good. All right. I could stay there for like another 2 minutes, but we gotta move on. So we're gonna press ourselves up.
Let's see. I'm gonna clip this guy back on real quick. All right. Now from here, we're gonna find a comfortable seat on our floor or yoga mat. We're just gonna relax those shoulders a bit. Get on the outside or the inner edges of the sit bones here so that the sit bones are nice and broad and the spine is extended. And what we're gonna do from here is just take our head around in a couple circles. Then once we feel like our neck is loosening out a little bit, then we're gonna work into some eagle arms. Now, I don't know how this is gonna quite work with the microphone, so I'm gonna try and hold it here. So what we're gonna do is cross our left arm underneath the right, and then we're gonna hold on to whatever we can here, a thumb, a finger. Now this is eagle arm, so what we want to do is lift the elbows. Oh yeah, so you probably will likely just feel that stretch already. So lifting the elbows and then pressing them away from you. Making little adjustments, maybe folding forward. Just feeling things out. Using your breath. Then we'll take about 2 to 3 more here. Again, don't lose sight of that lift and press, right? That's what we want to maintain here. And on this last breath, fill it up. And we will release. Shake it out a little bit. Man, I like shaking things out. It feels so good. Let's move on to the other side, shall we? So the right elbow is gonna go underneath the left. We're gonna grab onto what we can here. If I can find something. Let's use that watch. Yeah, perfect. And again, it might take us a second to find that stretch. But once you find it, it's about holding and breathing. Take your time. No rush. Lift, press, take 2 more. That one's great just to do at any time, right? If your shoulders are feeling tight, ooh, just stretch, open that up, and get it going. So, I think our next pose, we're gonna be focusing in on the glutes here. So, the most accessible position that I've found is starting with let's go with the left knee here. And what we're gonna do is pull the heel in and try and make a triangle shape with this knee. And then we're gonna take our other foot, the right foot, and cross it on top and over the left knee. Now the key here is to lift the heart, right? If I'm holding onto my knee and I lift the heart and push my sit bones back, I'm already feeling a good stretch. So let's take that a little bit further. Let's lift the heart, press the sit bones back, but then pull that knee in a little closer, right? So that's the key to this position. And I like to use my left arm to wrap around. I can get a little bit better leverage just by pulling towards my chest. Move it around a little bit. I like to rock forward and backward. Right? You can just kind of feel how the muscles shift, how they move. I'm going to take two more here. All right. I think a good way that we can top off this stretch for the glute is by finishing things in double pigeon. So we're in a really good place just to very gently reposition the legs. And if you've never done double pigeon before, you've got the knee over the foot, foot on top of the knee, stacked essentially so that the shins are parallel with whatever's in front of us. Now again, what I like to do is, of course, move around, you know, feel it out, maybe lean and press that knee in. That's where I can really start to feel that hip flexor lengthen, is when I lean to the left and then press my right hand into the right knee. So we just kind of move it downward. You want to be gentle, give some good energy to these muscle bands here. All right, very, very, very good. I think we're getting there. Let's take two more right here. All right, so I don't know that we're gonna jump right into the next side right off the bat. We're gonna shake out those legs a little bit. And I thought it'd be nice to stretch into the quads. And the way that we're gonna get into this position is very simple. We're gonna start with the right leg, so we're gonna kind of get into this same area here, same side, but we're gonna bend this knee and place our right foot on the outside of the bum here. So we're not sitting on the foot here, it's just on the outside, and you can leave the left leg straight, or you can even bring that left foot in to touch the right thigh. So once you have that all set up, we're gonna drop back through the left forearm, and just by dropping back through the left forearm, kinda like we're just lounging, you know, relaxed here, you're gonna feel a good stretch right in that concentrated area. And I'm gonna leave it up to you, right? What I'd like to offer, as far as adjustments goes, is just by lifting that knee a little bit, you stretch more into the quad. But if you press forward and up through the hips, ooh, hip flexor action all day right there. Keep your mind present as if you were the stretch, right? As if you were the quad. As if you were your right ankle. As if you were the breath coming into your lungs. All right, one more big stretch here. You want to peak that stretch. And then we'll release. So, swinging that back leg forward. Stick with me here, because we're just going to do a little switcheroo. We're going to pull that right heel in, create a triangle shape, take the left foot, place it on top, and over the right knee. But again, we want to stick out, and specifically sticking out through the left sit bone here. So we extend it out. I'm already feeling the stretch just by sitting in this kind of weird shape. But if I lift the heart, wrap that right arm around the knee, pull it close. And breathe. Then I think that we've found it. I think that we've gotten into the fruit and we've squeezed it into our glass. We're going to make some delicious juice. I think the practice is that it bears fruit, but I took it a step further and said that we took that fruit and we started to squeeze it. You know, like planting the seed. You start with planting the seed, you give energy to the seed, the seed grows, it expands, it receives energy from incoming vibration and frequency, it receives information, meaning us, our receiving apparatus in our physical form. See, we can almost look at our bodies like a receiving apparatus of frequency and vibration, almost like a television, okay? And what we do, and I'm speaking like an old television, of course. Imagine one with antennas, right, where you had to adjust the antennas. But before I finish up this little thing, this story, we're going to switch up into a double pigeon. Ugh, there we go. And set it up nice and comfortable for yourself. So imagine, right, our body is like a TV with antennas, and the yoga positions are really like the positioning of the antenna so that we can get a clear picture and clear audio, so we can receive clear frequency. We can only do this when we are receptive, clear, and open. And we don't have to be full of energy. That's not the point. It's to be ecstatic all of the time. It's really this kind of balance and this natural state of energy that we can be in, where we are open to receiving, yet we are very alert, right? It's when we're tired that we kind of cut off from receiving frequency and vibration, which is a very natural thing. It's a very human thing to do, is be tired, be awake, be neutral. In fact, that's the concept of the three gunas. The three gunas, huh? You can be tamas, sattvic, or rajasic. All right, I'd say we've done good work with this double pigeon pose. Let's move on to this thigh stretch here. So we're going to swing this left heel back behind us. You can choose the position of your right foot, but we're going to lean back into the right elbow. Right, I'm going to be honest, my left side today is feeling a lot tighter than my right. So it's just a good opportunity, if maybe you're feeling the same, just to make those adjustments. Maybe put a bit more energy into this side. Right, we got to open up those muscles so that they can realize their fullest potential. We have to strain them. We have to open. We don't have to, right? That's sorry. There's no have to. But if you want to grow, if your pursuit is growth and development, then it's a good idea just to take it to the, you know, next level, even if that's just centimeter by centimeter. That's it. Take two more. All right. shake out those legs. Our next pose is going to be Barokanasana. So whenever you're feeling ready, soles of the feet together. Me, I like to grab onto the toes. Feels like a good leverage point where we can pull the heart up, lift, get those sit bones off to the side. And as we lift, we can fold forward. Hopefully our senses have started to open up. That's the beautiful thing about practice. Our senses opening up. Our mind starting to relax. And we can truly begin to enjoy our experience once our senses are stimulated. I almost lost you guys there for a second. Gotta keep it together, gotta remember that zip code. That's what Ram Dass says. Because you can get as far out as you want. You just gotta remember your zip code. Or your social security number, either one. But man, doing these live classes are interesting because I'm doing it with you, whoever's here. But then my mind starts to melt. Melt into the position. And bringing it back is like, oh wait, yeah. There aren't people around me, but maybe there's someone watching. And if they are, hello, thank you. If not, then we can still keep doing the thing. It was like I was down at Green River last weekend, and my God, it was just the sun was hitting just right with the river and this beautiful peak. And I was chatting with my girlfriend. I said, you know, that beauty is there whether or not eyes are on it. Beautiful, beautiful nature there, even if no one is looking at it, right? So maybe as humans, we can adopt that same thing. I think, you know, being looked at, well, I won't go into that. All right, we're going to shake out the legs. I think, in fact, we're kind of coming up to the end of our practice. I really wanted to just to make this more of like a stretching routine, something really quick, 45 minutes. I don't know that we're going to do Shavasana, but maybe like a seated meditation for a couple minutes. So finding a nice comfortable seat. If you have something to sit on, it definitely helps to keep your hips elevated over the knees. So we're going to relax those shoulders, relax the face. And hopefully those senses are feeling very open and receptive. Just to receive the energy around us. Whatever you're focusing on, whatever you're thinking about, let it be there. Don't reject it. Don't even bring it in. Just observe. We find ourselves in the middle so that we can see both the clinging and the pushing away.